DES stands for Data Encryption Standard. Now, having understood the working operation of simplified DES, we can very easily understand the working operation of Data Encryption Standard. Now, DES takes in a 64-bit data as input, plain text, uses a 56-bit key, and then produces a 64-bit output, which is the ciphertext. Right? So here in DES, there are 16 rounds of operation. Which is usually referred to as FK. So there are 16 rounds of operation. So each operation would use a subkey. So we have seen that in SDS, that there are two rounds of operation, and each round of operation would need one subkey, right? So since there are 16 rounds of operation, we need 16 subkeys. So let me call that as K1 to K16. Okay? So what happens here? So initially in the key generation unit, we have a 56-bit key. So internally the algorithm generates 16 subkeys, each of length 48 bits. Okay, so all these keys, each of them are of, they are of length 48 bits. So that's very important. So there are 16 subkeys generated. And why is it that you have 16 subkeys? Because there are 16 rounds of operation. So let us briefly understand how DES operates when we talk about encryption. So we have 64-bit plain text, and then we have initial permutation. So initial permutation, all the 64 bits are permuted, and then you have the complex function FK. So remember, the block diagram is very similar to SDS. So these 64 bits are divided into two halves, left 32 and right 32. The left 32 would undergo a change, whereas the right 32 would go unaltered, right? So this is FK1. So the right 32 bits enter the complex function F. Enter the complex function F. And the first block is E/P. Right? So the first block is E/P, which is nothing but expansion and permutation. So in SDS, 4 bits were expanded and permuted and the output was 8. But here, the 32 bit is expanded and permuted to give 48 bits. Right? So now, these 48 bits are XORed with the first subkey K1, which is again of length 48. Right? And then we have the S boxes. So here in DES, there are 8 S boxes, S0 to S7. So there are 8 S boxes, S0 to S7. So since you have a 48-bit input and there are 8 S boxes, the input to each S box is 6 bits. And the output is 4. Okay, so 6 into 8 is 48. So here 4 into 8 is 32. So these 32 bits are further permuted. And then they are XORed with the left half. And then you get the left half which gets changed and the right half which goes unchanged. So now this is first round completed. these two halves are swapped. And in the second round of operation, what happens? The right 32 bits would undergo a change. Right? So after two rounds of operation, all the 64 bits have undergone a change. So this is repeated 8 times. Right? So for all 64 bits to undergo a change, we need two rounds of operation. Right? So like that, we have 8 sets. Okay? So each set having two rounds of operation, wherein each round will change 32 bits. So now let's see what happens. Well, how these S boxes are. So you have a 6-bit input. So let's assume that this is the input to one of the S boxes, right? So we observe in SDS, we observe that the first and the last bit indicated the row, whereas the middle two bits indicated the column operation. So even here, this is almost the same. The first and the last bit will indicate the row, whereas the middle four bits will indicate the column. Right. So now we will know how many rows and how many columns are there. So the row is 10, 2 bits. 2 bits meaning 4 combinations. So you have how many rows? 4 rows. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So here it's 10, which is row 2. 4 bits, which indicate the column. So that means there are 16 columns. Right? 4 zeros to 4 ones, 16 columns. So this is 1, 0, 1, 1. So what does that indicate? So this is 11. So you have column 11. So whatever data is there, so this matrix is a 4 cross 16 matrix, and all the values within this matrix will be a number between 0 and 50. So we'll have a value between 0 and 50. So the output of each S box will be a 4 bit data. So why is it a 4 bit data? Because the value varies between 0 and 15, which can be represented by a 4 bit combination. So therefore the output of each S box is 4. Right? So like this, you have 16 rounds of operation, and then after the 16th round we have IP inverse, and then finally we get the ciphertext, which is of length 64 bits.